Okay, hello from the Orthodox Church Anna, and we will talk about the prayer of the heart. So what we have today to talk?
Because sometimes they ask us how to pray about the practice.
A little bit louder because you cannot hear what it is.
Sometimes they ask about how to pray, about the practice and details. Like because some prayer will be the Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. And then somebody say, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me. Even some people say you can just focus on the name Lord Jesus or even Jesus. So is this any difference or any meaning?
There is not any big difference. But of course, everybody must ask some spiritual father. But for me, it's better to be more simple. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me. Just this, okay? The most important is, as I say, to concentrate on the words of the prayer and not on other things, okay? So it's much more better. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me. Of course, if we say this. Lord Jesus Christ, we mean theology behind, because Jesus Christ is the Son of God, so we say about the Holy Trinity, and of course we accept what is the mercy of God and all these things, okay?
就是我请教神父的是说，因为有的人他们会说祷词的部分，你是要说比方说像是主耶稣基督，然后上帝的儿子怜悯我罪人，还是说主耶稣基督上帝的儿子怜悯我，那还是说主耶稣基督怜悯我，甚至是只有说主耶稣。那事实上神父的意思是说这样子其实这些祷词之间并没有太大的就是差别，但是他会比较建议你是使用比较简单的方式，比较简单的祷词，比方说像是主耶稣基督怜悯我或主耶稣怜悯我。那重要的是说你要把就是你的注意力集中在就是这样子的祷词上面，而不是在你心里面的就是情感或者是思想或者是其他的感受上面。那另外是说，其实即使你是只有说这么简单的祷词，像是主耶稣怜悯我或主耶稣基督怜悯我，事实上他都已经就是解释了跟宣示了就是教会里面有关于圣三一的这个信仰，大概是这个意思。
Okay, so I think I answered maybe not correct, but it's my poor advice, okay? Yeah.
And
what else?
And they say when you pray, you pray just oral practice, or better you just recite in
your... No. The oral practice is not the most proper, because first of all, this will create a problem in the throat, okay? If somebody is talking all the time, he will have problem. Yes.
那另外有人是在问说，那像这样子的祈祷人在练习的时候，就是你是要出声祷告吗？比方说你是一直就是出声音附送主耶稣怜悯我这样子的祈祷词，还是说你在心里面就是默念就好？那神父他的意思是说，就是最好其实不需要出声，因为如果你一直出声这样子祷告的话，事实上过度使用喉咙器可能是会伤害到你的就是声带。
And from the other point of view, but of course, if somebody cannot concentrate, he can try a little bit orally in difficult times, because many times we cannot, for different reasons of life, we cannot concentrate. Okay, but the most important is first to start to say in his mind. Okay.
那就是口祷，就出声祷告。这个时候是说，比方说，当你在非常困难，没有办法集中你的注意力的时候，那你在这样子的时候，你才用出声祷告的方式。那或者一般就是一般通常的方式，都是你都是先就是从在心里面默念这个祷词开始。
And if we say in the mind, it is up to the grace of God. The mind to be united with the heart, but this is not up to us.
那就是说，当我们在心里附送这样子的祷词的时候，如果有神的恩典的祝福的话，那我们会就是体会到所谓的就是我们的心智跟我们的就是心灵的一个就是结合。但是这个是取决于就是神的恩典，这不是取决于我们自己的努力或是什么样的方式。Anything
else? What else?
Yeah. They ask because they read the way of the pilgrim.And actually, the elders tell the pilgrim, count the times, count how many times you pray with Jesus' prayer. But some others say, better not to count, because when you count how many times, you will lose your concentration. You just have a bell. And,
this is what I say also. First of all, because the ancient people, they have not electronic clocks and...iPhones, iPads, and this. Today, it is better not to count and just put your telephone or your clock to work. And after 10 minutes, for example, it can do this and it's okay. So there is no problem.
Okay. 那因为就是
Yes.
像我们在那个就是因为有本书，它是叫《朝圣者之旅》。那里面，他是有介绍到说，就是有一个朝圣者，然后，有一个政教的修道院的长老建议他说，就是你每次要念几次的这个耶稣道文。但是神父他的意思是说，因为在那个时代，他们并没有像我们现在这样子的计时器，所以他们需要去算那个次数。那如果是像我们现代人，其实很方便，你就是用一个闹钟或是用你的手机都可以设定的时间，那你不需要去特别算那个次数，等时间一到。就是你自然就知道哦，时间到了。其实这样子的方式也是好的。
Yeah, because if somebody stays in counting and this, it will not be for him very. It can say, oh, I must. For example, if you say to him, you must say 100 times, he can say very fast or very slow or this. It is not. You must.This is why I say we must concentrate in the words and say slowly and just with a pure heart as it is possible and not trying to have like a mind exercise. How many times and how fast and what is the speed?
就是说因为不要用这种就是算次数的方式，是因为它会变得好像有点我们在做就是运动或练习那样子的一种计算，那这样子反而会让你比较没有办法专心在就是祷词上面。那因为事实上比较适当的因为你在算次数的时候，你很可能会在想说，我到底做了几次？然后那如果我要在短时间里面完成这些次数，我是不是要很快的把它念完呢？那事实上这些担心都会让你就是比较没有办法就是专心在祈祷上面。所以事实上你就是用一个就是计时器，然后提醒你时间到了，其实这样子就可以了。And they also ask about before you say when pray with Jesus prayer, should we very rush and very fervently or just we calm and slowly?
Important is to be calm and slowly and to concentrate in the words.
所以比较重要的就是你在念的时候其实不用很赶，你就是慢慢的平静的然后稳定的去念这个祷词，然后集中在这个祷词上面就可以了。
It is important because sometimes there will come very good thoughts also during this period. For example, thoughts to become better, to pray, to study Bible, the different memories of the Bible will come. This is not good.
那当你在祈祷的时候，可能会有一些好的念头，就是进到你的就是脑海里面。比方说，我要变得更好啦，我要读经啦，我要做研究啦，或是我要做些什么服事啦，什么事情。那事实上，不要。
For the prayer of the heart, this is actually a distraction.
那是可是当这些念头是他们虽然是好的念头，可是当你在祈祷的时候，这些念头却是会。变成让你分心的一个念头是不需要的，是不好的。
It is a distraction because these thoughts is very strange. They will appear this time, but later, when we finish, they will not appear.
而且很特别的是，你会注意到这些良善的美好的念头，很奇怪的是，他们只有在你祈祷的时候，他们才会出现，好像是要来就是分散你的注意力。可是当你结束祈祷，回到你的生活当中的时候，这些念头却不会出现。
And they will not appear. They will not appear. So it is a distraction. And finally, instead of concentrating the name of Jesus Christ, we will concentrate on the Bible, which is not bad. But we have all the other time to do this.
那是说这样子的念头，甚至是说如果你是在祈祷的时候，然后这个念头出现说，我们来读圣经，我们来想圣经的这个里面的经文或句子，那像这样的念头，它就是只有在祈祷的时候才会出现，目的是要就是分散你的注意力。可是当你结束祈祷的时候，它反而就不会再出现来提醒你做这样子的事。
And as I say, it is different. What is our purpose? If our purpose is to work for the prayer of the heart as a very special thing, okay? As a very special deep Christian exercise.
那重要的就是我们把我们的注意力放在祈祷，我们就是耶稣祷文本身，然后不要去注意其他的念头，那这样子才有可能体会到它比较就是深刻的一个层次这样。
What else?
Does it any special like you sit or you do any special posture or something?
Now about the body, the fathers of the church, they first of all, the prayer of the heart is not a technique. It's not a kind of yoga.
那我请教神父的是，那像耶稣祷文，他有任何需要特定的一个就是身体的姿势吗？比方说像禅坐，他就一定要打坐。那神父的意思是，耶稣就是心祷，它不是一种就是所谓的冥想，不是一种瑜伽，所以没有特定的身体的姿势。
But the fathers of the church they advise because we are human beings, and because we are not.Controlling ourselves 100%. Okay, this is a gift of God. So there are some advices. Okay, not techniques. But these techniques, we must understand that they are in Philokalia. They are not for everybody.
那因为教父他们知道说，就是我们人类没有办法，就是完全100%的控制我们的心智。所以他会建议一些有的时候会建议一些特定的就是姿势或技巧来帮助你集中你的注意力，但是我们要注意这些姿势或这些技巧，它不是给每一个人，不是适用每一个人的。
So we must first of all see a danger that many people have. They read a book for monks and they forget.That this book is for monks and not for them.
那我们要特别注意，因为其实像有些人，他们会读他会读一些就是写给修道院的修士或修女的这种灵修书籍。那他就照着里面的就是这个建议或技巧去做，可是他却没有想到，就是这些书事实上是给特定的，就是特定的人来读的。
But from the other point of view, if we take the blessing of Some spiritual father, then, and I say this because in Taiwan the people don't have the concept of the spiritual direction.
那事实上最好的一种方式是，当你在操就是实践或练习心导的时候，你最好是有所谓的属灵父亲或属灵母亲的建议。但比较不幸的是，就是在台湾，事实上很多的信徒或是很多的基督徒，他们并没有这种要寻求属灵指导的这种观念。
Even there are people who say I'm Christian, but I don't belong to any church, which is a heretic thing, because Jesus created church, not individuals who follow a book.
那甚至就是有一些基督徒，他们会有这样子的观念，是说我是基督徒，可是我并不属于任何一个特定的教会。但事实上，这样子的一种想法，它是一种异端的想法。因为耶稣他创造了教会，而不是他创造了教会，而并不是说我是一个个体，然后我有一本圣经，我就是基督徒。
The prayer of the heart is not an achievement like to say, oh, I can do miracles, I can do this, I can do this. It's not like this. It's to make us more humble, not more proud.
所以心导它就是它事实上它是要帮助我们，让我们变得就是更谦卑，而不是说好像我们在练习一种特定的瑜伽技巧，然后就是练得很厉害，然后觉得自己非常骄傲这样。
So the fathers of the church they advise, if you want, you can stay in a very peaceful place, for example, in your room.Okay, and close, of course, the TV and what you have, and you know, sit in a, somewhere peacefully, not sit like this, but sit like this, because gradually you will sleep if somebody is doing this. Okay, after a few times, he can sleep.
那就是说，教皇他们就会建议，比方说，你可以在你的房间里面，然后当然就是关掉电视啦、手机这些会让你分心的东西，然后你的坐姿可能就是要坐直，就是你的背不要贴在椅子上面，因为贴久了，事实上你就会就是想睡。
And they advise to close our eyes and have a little bit like the, to the direction of the heart like this.
那他另外他会教父们他们会建议说，你可以就是把头就是。低下来，然后好像是 your eyes look to
me. Yeah, not the eyes closed, the eyes closed, but just to the direction of the heart, like I am like this.
那这个姿势的意思是你会闭上你的眼睛，那样子姿势看起来就好像是就是你的注意力或你的眼睛的这个方向是注视着你的心的。
And you know, gradually to start with the mind.To say, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me.
然后就是你渐渐的，就是开始，一次又一次的附送，就是主耶稣基督怜悯我，主耶稣基督怜悯我。
And Saint Simon the New Theologian and Saint Gregory of Sinai, he advises because the thoughts they will come, many thoughts they will come and go. It is better for the beginner to have like when he breathes.Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me when he, you know, takes out.
那有一些教父他们也会建议说，你可以透过呼吸，然后来帮助你自己，就是让你的注意力就是更集中一些。比方说，像是当你吸气的时候，你就说主耶稣基督，然后呼气的时候你就说怜悯我。
But gradually, again, having some kind of rhythm can be, for example.Or a prayer rope, or even the pulses of our heart, or this. Okay.
那另外有一种方式是你让你的祈祷的念诵祈祷，我们的就是有一个节奏。那这个节奏你可以透过，比方说你用数所谓的祈祷神的方式，或者是说你甚至是透过跟你的这个脉搏一同跳跃的这种方式，也是一种有节奏的方式。
Many people because they are.They confuse the prayer of the heart and with dazhuo they will ask details. For example, the hands could be like this or like this, like this or like this. It's in the Eastern religions, every body position has to do with religious things behind. But in Christianity, it's not like this.
那很多人他们就是会把心导跟东方的就是冥想或瑜伽联想在一起，所以他们就会问很多有关于身体技巧细节的问题，比方说你的手势啦、你的坐姿啦等等的。那在东方的宗教里面，这些东西有它的就是特定的宗教意义，可是，在基督教里面是不需要这些东西的。
So it is not important to say the legs will be closed or open, the hands will be like this or like this or like this or like this.It's not because once more I say in the Eastern religions every movement has behind a religious meaning. In Christianity, it has not.
那神父要再次强调说，所以你的脚是，比方说你坐着的时候是张开或合起来，然后你的手的姿势是怎么样的？这些在心导的实践里面是不重要的，你不需要去在乎这些细节。那当然，在东方宗教里面有就是有它的这个意义，那我们是不一样的。
And once more, this is, we must not forget that this is for the beginning. And our purpose is not to achieve something, but to allow Jesus to enter to our heart.
那我们也要再次的，就是认识到说，就是心祷，它最终的目的是要让耶稣进到我们的心里面，而不是说我们靠着操练某种技巧达到什么特定的境界或成就。
And of course, the prayer of the heart is a very important thing in the Christian life. But the most important thing in the Christian life is the Holy Communion. Okay, so somebody cannot say, "No need to go to the church because I'm peacefully in my house and I do the prayer of the heart."
那当然，就是基督徒的灵性生活里面，心祷是非常重要的。但是有另外一个更重要的，就是教会的这个圣礼，这个圣体，就是圣餐礼或是圣体圣事。那这个其实是所以一个人并不能说哦，我只要心祷就好，那我其实也不需要再到教会去，就是参加任何的圣事了。这样子的态度是不对的。
So I think we can stop here and we will continue for more details in our next meetings. Okay, thank you.